Hello everyone, Phoenix Valley here, and welcome back to another Farming Simulator 15 mod spotlight. So today we got a ton of pickup trucks and trailers to do, and then next one Friday, we'll have a ton of semis and trailers to do. we got all kinds of stuff. We got a Jeep here, we have a Silverado, of course we're gonna go purple. Trailers, we have a fifth wheel camper, we have a little loader here. We've done these already. And over here we have a Chevy, a Ford. I think these two are the same, just one's black and one's pink. We'll buy it just in case. A couple more. We have all of these semis to do. And we have this Dodge here. And I think we have... yeah, right here. Alright. Holy cow. So much to do. Alright. Wowzers. Okay. So let's start with the Dodge. Start it up. We're gonna drive it away from here. There we go. Now, the Offspring, or he's calling himself Offspring Gaming now. Back when I used to watch him, it was the Offspring, as you can see there. Whoa. I used to watch his videos all the time before I started YouTube, and then it kind of, I don't really have time to watch videos between editing mine, recording mine, and everything. So I rarely get to catch up with videos, and I recently just caught up with his, and I've been watching him again, like I said, about the mobile homes pack. And he's got a modding group together, and one of the first trucks they put out would be this one here. Let's pull around in here. And he gave him permission to go ahead and do their trucks, and this trailer is by them also. What the heck? He gave me permission to go ahead and do it and post their links to them. Probably just post a link to his video. I don't know yet. Or if there'll definitely be a link to his video in the description. But he's got this one, and then he's got a single single rear wheel version of this, meaning non-dually, for some reason I just can't get in my game. And if you guys are having problems with getting this in game, you put the zip file in your mods folder, and then you extract that folder into your mods. You extract what's in the zip folder out into your mods folder also, so you should have a zip file with the name and then a folder with the name in your mods, and that's what worked for me. If you're having problems with it, this one I didn't have that problem. It was the trucks that gave me the problem. But for the truck, I'm gonna give a 5 out of 5. It looks awesome. The only problem I have with it is this invertedness. I don't like it. And Rambo actually has a video on how to fix that. The interior is not fully detailed, but the exterior looks super awesome. I'm not seeing any problems with it at all. Except your sign doesn't match the rest of the truck. Just kidding. The trailer I played around with some, I'm gonna give it 5 out of 5. Also, the only problem I have seen with it is when you go to load a when you go to load a when you go to load a hold on, we gotta do that again.
Puny dodges.
Like when I went to load that GMC truck on here, it for some reason it got stuck right here. I don't know what's the deal with that, but any other truck loaded just fine. So that means the GMC doesn't need to be towed around. Anyway, 5 out of 5 for both of these. Let's tab over. Oh, as you can see there, I forgot to sell some stuff off. Let's do the other offspring truck while we're at it. Will this fit on here? Yeah, it will. The backup lights also, for some reason, just like headlights, lag my game. Rolling. Oh crap, I forgot. This truck, or the trailer, was released by Alaska. I can't remember, I'm terrible with numbers after names, but he's part of Arctic Wolf Modding, and they have been trying to get me into their TeamSpeak server. And I keep forgetting about it. My bad, guys, if you're watching. But yeah, they put out this trailer here. Alright, for the camper, I'm going to give it a 4 out of 5. The reason I'm going to give it a 4 out of 5 is because it's all one color. I would like to see, like, even just a pattern to break it up. Go in it. Invisible walls. I can see everything going on around. This is genius. That doesn't look right. Anyway. Like, I know the 13 version had some kind of design on it. It just broke it up some. Full white, just, it looks like, it just looks like a shape, if that makes sense. but it works. Let's check out the lights. Lights work. What about turn signals? Do you turn signals without? No. I've started up. Okay, so the turn signals on the trailer work, turn signals on the truck don't work. So yeah, I'm going to give a 4 out of 5 for that. The truck, I'm going to give a 4 out of 5. It seems a little bit underscaled compared to the other trucks that we had up over there. And the blinkers don't work. And it's the same thing on the interior. Convert it and not fully detailed. And I'll bring that other Chevy over here just to show you guys what I mean by the scale. So 4 out of 5 for this. It looks awesome. It's just a couple minor things wrong with it. Alright, let's jump in game. And one thing they point out, it's one of the very few trucks that are have an actual bed on it. It's not a flat bed. Alright, tab over. Will this thing do that trailer? I'm guessing. No, I'll save this. Save for the Chevy. Don't want to break the Ford. Yeehaw. Holy hell, look at that exhaust pipe. kind of want to make sure this. And then kind of you bring that other trailer over here. Whoops. Alright. We're going to postpone that for a minute. Jeep's so small you can't even tell it's there. Alright, let's hop into this. I don't know why they added this feature, but you can ride with it like a lowrider. Because I don't know why they added that feature, but it's there. I think I would like it better if it was like right about there, like right here, so up as high as it is. I wish you could like stop it, but you can't. The attacher points off on it also. Yeah, the trucks are going to be all wonky now because mods, period, are going to be all wonky now because from what I understand in 1.3, I think it's patch 1.3, yeah, they fixed the sliding issues. Now all the trucks that have their wheels, the weight of the wheels or whatever jacked up, they're going to act wonky and you'll see that. And I'll think probably Friday's video. I don't remember. All right. This is what I mean about scale. You see the size difference? They're the same truck. Let's lower it down. Even with it lowered, you can tell this is much bigger. Like, this is lowered, practically sitting on the ground, and the cabs are just about the same height. So you can see that scaling is a huge issue with me. I like all my stuff to be the same size, or roughly, and it seems like each monitor has their own scale, if that makes sense. Okay, that hooks up. And that might be actually scaled and this be overscaled. I can't answer that. It's just it's just a thing to do, that just something that happens in the modding community. Nobody works off the same scale, if that makes sense. So this truck will give a 5 out of 5. I really don't know what goes on with this green here. It happens on all these Chevys, so I have no clue what's going on with that. But despite that, we'll give a 5 out of 5. The interior. Oop. We did that, didn't we? The interior is the same as that GMC. Oh, they actually put the Chevy's logo. Oh, that's pretty cool. It looks nice and everything. I just wish it had different rims on. I'm not a big fan of those rims. But 5 out of 5 for that. I went to test to make sure this actually, the hitch on this worked. Ooh. There we go. Yep, it works. This is another, we put off so we can test to make sure that both attachers work. Yeah, that works. Alright. Beep beep. Coming in. Alright. Alright. So this one I'll give a 5 out of 5. They've fixed the bed being a different color problem. Oh wow, he actually posted it. That's awesome. And it's a lot better than the early versions that come out. So 5 out of 5. Looks great. Time to pop on over. I think this is the exact same thing, just paint. So we're just going to park this over here. Now this one is off-road. Oh. It's got some bite. Oh. Whoop. Don't ask, because I have no clue what that was all about. I think this is basically the same thing, just with tracks instead of... That sound file, though. Hey, I wonder if I can cut that tree down. Oh, God. So yeah, this is practically the same thing, just has tracks on a different sound file, so I'll give it a 5 out of 5 too. And I think this is the same thing also. Looks like it. So, that's good. Do it for the... Oh wait, we forgot the Jeep. My bad. Don't yell at me. Somebody actually just recently asked me if there was a Jeep out. I did not know there was one. Whoa. Whoa. That works. I'll give this a 4 out of 5. My problem with it is it's a little hard to handle. It slides around, but other than that, it looks great. It actually runs. Just handling, and man, I really hope they finally figure out what's going on with this handling problem and get it fixed ASAP, because yeah, this whole sliding issue is just getting old. But that's gonna do it for today, guys. If you liked the video, be sure to leave a like down below. If you guys want to see more of Farming Simulator 15 mod spotlights, be sure to click subscribe, and as always, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.